Hello everyone, my name is Nate Harms and today I thought I'd show you all how I got high quality DVR working on my Tinyhawk 2 Freestyle. So first of all, supplies. You're going to need a DVR board. There's quite a few on the market. I bought one that is no longer for sale, but I'll try to link a few extras in the description that may work for this project. Now, most of them take a 5 volt input with a not insignificant input amperage. Now the problem with the Tinyhawk board is it doesn't like feeding any external modules. So in order to solve this, I ended up going and getting these buck converters off of Amazon. I think I got a pack of 5. It was actually fairly cheap. They worked great. I used them for several different projects as well, not necessarily relating to drones. So I'll link those here. You're also going to want, I ended up putting a full-size KDX Raytel camera on my drone. I'll leave a link in the description for the STL file that will allow you to replace the standoffs on the front with a bit of a camera mount that will actually hold this camera. If you end up having a crash head first with this camera, there's a not insignificant chance that you will damage it. But it's fairly easy to install. The wiring is the exact same as on the stock camera. So you basically just flip them out. If you use JST connectors, you won't have to do basically any soldering as long as you can get the wires to the right length. Now, a few of you will probably have a good laugh, but I really I didn't have any spare JST connectors, and I really hate de-pinning and re-pinning them, especially ones with solder on them. So I ended up just splicing the old JST connector to some wires coming out of my Raytel camera. This benefited me because I ended up running one extra video wire that's going to be used for the DVR, and I made sure to leave enough length that I could run that wire underneath the frame. I'm going to be mounting, or I have mounted, the DVR board to the underside of the frame with just some zip ties. I could have 3D printed something like a more proper mount, but this is kind of just hacked together real quick. Honestly, I didn't expect it to work too much. For the buck converter is going to be your main power source to the DVR board. So you want to solder the leads to it, the positive and negative leads, directly to the board where the battery connects. Be careful when you do this, just to make sure that you don't accidentally disconnect your battery leads. Make sure there's good contact with both wires, and leave enough wire so you can run these underneath your board and under the frame for the DVR. From there, it's pretty simple. You run your positive and negative to the DVR, your video to the DVR, and probably wise to add some shielding. I did a little bit of aluminum foil underneath a piece of shrink tube just to hold everything together and isolate the signal. You can also twist your ground wire around the video. The main problem is with splicing that you can get a little bit of signal interference, especially with that much wire on such a small drone. So get that all wired up to your DVR, zip tie it to the bottom in some way where you can access both the SD card and the button. As you can see, what I've done is I've had the SD card facing out the back way of the drone, and the button actually fits between my two zip ties here. You can, of course, do this all with the stock camera as well. I just wanted a little bit better quality, and I didn't have a nano Raytel to use. I just had this one lying around, so that's why I made the adapter. Hope this helps you guys figure out how to do it, and good luck.